Hola. Thank you, Mr. President, and it's a pleasure to be here. La Zagaleta has been a wonderful host for me and my family for the last week. To carry on with what the Mr. President was saying, my name is Ten Damkivi, and for the last 7 years, I've been building Skype. I've been an IT entrepreneur in Estonia for the past 15. So as the theme of the conference here or forum here today is about brands and trends, I think Skype should fit in quite well. First of all, I would like to know how many of you actually use Skype. I love you too. In that sense, I will skip explaining what the product is. It's a little piece of free software you can use to make calls all over the world. And I will tell you a bit more about maybe what's less known or a bit more hidden about the company who builds that product. So Skype is just 8 years old. And we started in 2003. We started with this simple release of software that four Estonian engineers built, and we put it to the market. And a few months later, we had already the first 1 million users. And ever since that, it's been a roller coaster ride. I mean, 8 years ago, we had zero users. Today, we have 250 million people who use Skype every month. We have had over 1 billion signups to the service over the years. 8 years ago, we had Niklas Zennström and Janus Fries, a Swede and a Dane, respectively, and four Estonian engineers who got together to build this product. Now we have about 1,400 employees across the world in 10 different countries, and Estonia is still the largest office that we have. We have 400 people back home. 8 years ago, we were a year off from launching our first paid product, which is Skype Out, which lets you to call to regular phones and this old school stuff. And now we make about $1 billion of revenue out of that. And all of those things have happened in less than a decade, which is quite amazing, and I think tells you miles about what internet and the new technologies and sort of these enabling new ways of doing things have enabled to people coming from small remote places in the world to do to actually conquer the world. So coming from that backdrop of this roller coaster of doing things, I thought I'd share with you a few of the sort of underlying trends or these macro things that have influenced the evolution of Skype product and the brand. Of course, many of them, or some of them, you could say that are specific to the internet. It's these things that kids do these days, and they might not be applicable to some things like building really exclusive real estate properties. But I hope there are some things that you still find relevant about those. So first of all, when Skype started, we started diverse and international from our DNA. We're extremely proud of our Estonian heritage and the fact that that we come from Northern Europe, and usually, it's funny, when I travel the world and talk about Skype, when you say that you're on the internet and you're successful, then the presumption is that you must be from US. So actually, 8 years ago, coming out of Europe and becoming global output of Europe is something that we took extreme pride of. At the same time, we have been very diverse in our DNA. So the first six people behind Skype already were three different nationalities. Today, the 400 people building Skype in Estonia alone, we have 30 different nationalities working in the building. So I strongly believe that in today's world, you cannot build a global brand or a global product without being international in your DNA. So you have to diversify, you have to get people on the board. You cannot presume that an Estonian engineer will know what kind of software will a Chinese user love versus the Brazilian user. You have to get those people into your organization and into your network. Secondly, I would like to emphasize the passion for the product. When we ask the people today who work for Skype, why do they do that? Why did they join us? And we are hiring, this first half of the year alone, we're hiring 400 people. And when you go back to those people, throughout all the years, we've had number two answers. Sometimes they switch spaces, but basically the top two answers are still the same. One is the opportunity to work with people smarter than you. That tells you how you have to manage your hiring bar, which you can't never lower. And the second is the passion for the product. The fact that you actually can go out and change the world is something that that enables you to attract the best talent into your organization. And in case of Skype, it's really true. It's like when I fly over the ocean, then I can choose if I want to sleep or if I want to talk about Skype. And the only difference is the Skype sticker on my computer. The second I take out my computer, somebody will approach me in 20 minutes and wants to explain how they use Skype and what they want to be different and all of that. And that's extremely powerful. It's every year there are tens of thousands of companies that are established with the goal of changing the world, but it's really amazing when you're actually inside doing that and you're getting that feedback from the users. Another trend that actually is a quote of one of our founders, Nicholas, that he used to iterate on and on again. It's not the big who win the small, it's the fast who win the slow. And that's something that again, you could say that Skype with 1,400 people is becoming like sort of a, it's not an SME really anymore, especially after we were acquired by Microsoft last year for $8.5 billion, and now we have 96,000 new colleagues. But still, the Skype division in Microsoft is 1,400 people, and it's not that many. At the same time, if you look at the number of the users we have, and you convert that to users per employee, it exceeds 1 million. So it's pretty cool that you actually go to work in the morning and you're taking care of 1 million customers. And the other metric that I really like is that Tallinn in Estonia has 400,000 people. Every morning I drive to work, I can think of 400,000 users that we added last day. So it's sort of, you walk, look out of the car window and every person on the street, you can imagine these are the new users that joined the service in the last 24 hours. So it is about being nimble, being fast, being really efficient, being really using the technologies to enable scale that you could not have dreamt about before. And one more thing is that what has made, I think what has been really helpful for Skype's development of the culture and the approach to product development that we have is that we cannot really focus on competition for a very simple reason. If you look at Skype and we do calling and video calling and text messaging and chatting across the internet, you can look at any big internet brand like Google, Yahoo, Microsoft, Apple, Facebook, all of these guys have their own communication offering. Then if you think about our users sit in a country wherever they happen to be, and Skype happens to be in 225 countries and territories in the world, and they sit in their home country and think, okay, I want to call my mom or my friend in Australia. They have to choose between a mobile phone, a landline phone, some other internet software, or Skype. So actually, in addition to the top internet brands, all of a sudden we are competing with about 500, 700 telcos in the world, even though we are not a telecom ourselves with this little piece of software. And then you can look at all the startups that are popping up all over the world trying to address some of the mobile communication topics or some other topics. And you can consider those in your competitors as well. And all of a sudden you have 1,000 people, 1,000 companies around the world, many of them really, really rich, playing in a $1 trillion-plus marketplace of communications. And who do you choose to compete? What we have done in response is actually we've faced ourselves much more towards our own product and much more towards our users, and have not spent much time following what others are doing or trying to chase them. And again, to quote Nicholas, our founder, on that topic, when you see somebody's, when you're running in a competition and you see your competition running next to you, then that means that they're not behind you anymore. So it's sort of focusing on your users and focusing on the road ahead and doing your own thing is something that we found extremely helpful to build a company in such a quick time. Coming from this background and looking at this success story of a single corporation, I would like to link back to Estonia now. I think many of those aspects, being agile, being nimble, being very small, doing amazing things with a very small number of people, and getting the best people together and just getting stuff out of the door and seeing how it works and what flies and what not. These are all of the things that I'm really proud as an Estonian that are also characteristic to Estonia as a country. In a way, if you think that the Estonia got re-independent from the Soviet occupation just 20 years ago, Estonia as a country is still a startup as well. And that's something that I find, as a technology entrepreneur, I find extremely cool. And Skype as an organization, despite we're global now, we are still extremely proud of our Estonian roots. So thanks for your attention, and thanks, Lazar Galetta, for hosting us today.